subscribers.
It's a Vickers Kit, guys. It's a Vickers Kit. Project 1.1, Sir Victor Bo. By the intro of this video, as well as the title and the thumbnail of this video, you guys already know that I bought myself a new project car, and it turned out to be a Fiat Uno. I wasn't planning on buying this specific car, but it was up for a good price, and by chance it was a old friend of mine that was selling the car, and I paid a deposit on the car, so I will be doing a monthly installment on this car as well. And hopefully I can get the car paid off by the middle of this year. But the crap thing about the car is that the license is actually behind like by 3-4 years. So that's like the off-putting part of the entire sale. And that's why I bought the car, I guess. Because then I can pay the car off and I can also still like pay up the license. And for the amount of money I paid for the car and for the amount I still need to pay for the license, that will still be a little bit less than buying a Uno on the market at the moment, if it makes sense like that. And that's the reason why I bought the car, because number one, I kind of need a daily, and that's why I bought the car. And this car is perfect for daily. Like, the car wasn't empty. I threw in the 200 rands of petrol and the car literally went to off. I mean, like, whatever car would ever do that? A 1.1 Uno.
It's only game. Why you have to be mad?
And that's the reason why I bought the car, because I literally only travel, I would say, 5 kilometers to college and back each day. And my class is gonna start like in the next 2 weeks. So obviously, this will be a nice investment for me for petrol usage as well. And it's light on fuel, and I can still save up for the respray of the yellow thing. And I can save up on petrol money as well by literally just driving this car every single day. So that's still quite right. It's just I still need to cover the license that is behind. But I still will eventually do that. But the car is in such a good condition. It has just a little bit of rust on here and there. The car's paint needs a little bit of TLC. And I didn't check out the interior in depth yet. But the interior needs a nice clean. It has seat covers on. And I still need to check how the seats look underneath the seat covers. I still need to remove the seat covers, everything like that. I got the front load in the car. I got some speakers in the car. I got the rims on the car. So that was quite right for the amount of money I paid for the car. So I'm just going to take you guys through the entire car, because I know a few of you guys are excited for this project. And I know a few of you guys were like, fuck! I was initially going to buy another Honda or another Golf. But like I said, this happened by accident, and to be honest, I really like the car. Today, Tyron will be buffing my car. So, as you guys can see, like, the paint definitely needs some TLC. We just wiped the car off, but as you guys can see right there, the car's paint definitely needs some TLC. So, we're gonna try to at least get the paint a little bit fresh by literally just buffing the car. And hopefully that will solve our problem for the time being. But the car is quite neat on the inside. There's no cracks on the dashboard, just like a few scuffs. We have a front lid on the car, the cabrio works, the blower works, the indicators works, the lights works. All the gears go in. It's just third gear has like a little bit of scrape on it if you put it in third gear really, really fast. But otherwise, everything is quite fine. And all the window liners work. This car has central locking in. It's just, I'm not sure if I will be able to lock the car. I still need to check out that. But the car is quite neat and quite alright. And I haven't checked like how it looks underneath those seat covers. But I will be removing the seat covers in this video. I will be giving the car a nice clean on the inside as well as on the exterior of the car. And the fourth rim of the car is in the trunk, because for some reason the previous owner stated that the wheel keep on going flat, and that's the reason why the spare is on. So I most probably think I need to replace the tire, or just need to check out why the tire keeps on blowing off. But for now, the spare wheel will have to do the trick. And obviously, guys, I won't be rolling with these wheels for long. I will eventually be changing the rims and obviously the tires. And guys, if any of you guys know a method to drop these kind of cars, I know there has been a rumor saying that some kind of Corsa's coilovers actually works in this car, actually fits this car. So if anyone knows which coilovers will fit in this car, or which way I can drop the car, and I don't want to cut the car because I think the shocks need replacing, and in that way I can one time just buy coilovers or something for this car. So if anyone knows how to drop a Fiat Uno, please do comment down below. But guys, this car is quite alright for the amount of money I paid for the car. Unfortunately, I can't tell you guys how much I paid for the car, because I just can't tell you guys. When I got the license paid up and I got everything sorted out, maybe I can tell you guys then how much I'm in the car. But at the time, I can't tell you guys how much I paid for the car. As you guys can see here, we will definitely be needing an exhaust on this car as well. I know exhaust won't be worth it on this car, but I would just like exhaust on the car just for the looks. And a nice tailpiece on the car. Obviously, I will be displaying the bumpers black. And obviously the car definitely needs an exhaust, because
okay,
I would like some sound on this car, to be honest. And I don't know if many of you guys know this, but this car is actually a 1.1, and this tank is half by simply just throwing in a 200 rand petrol. So that's quite alright. But I'll take you guys a little bit through the car later. I'll take you guys for a drive in the car later. But for now, we're just going to give the car a nice polish. I don't know what forky shit is here on the bonnet, but Tyrant threw everything on the bonnet. So we're just going to get the car a little bit buffed. And yeah, as soon as we're done here, then we can show you guys the results, if there's any results on this car. But I'll put you guys on a time as well. We'll be busy buffing the car and giving the car a nice clean. Just keep in mind, we still need to clean the engine bay as well, but we might just do that on another day. But today is just taking you guys around the car, getting you guys up to date with this new project, and maybe just set out the list of what modifications can be done to the car, and what is affordable and what is not affordable. Oh, yeah.
Can we start now?
Well, guys, we're gonna start buffing the car. I'll put you guys in the timers while we'll be busy sorting out this bird stuff on this bonnet here. Well, guys, I'm just gonna give you guys a nice drive in the Uno. This is the new project, as all of you guys already know. I really like made a video before this, then my phone like really got like super hot, and then the video was like never saved. So let's hope this video saves this time. But the car really drives like very, very nice. I'm just gonna take you guys around the block for a nice test drive in this car. And then I just want to state a few things with the car. Is that, like, yeah, a lot of stuff I want to change on the car. Like, obviously I want to drop the car and put some rims on the car and stuff like that. And I really removed the seat cover, so obviously the seats needs a nice clean, because the seats are super dirty, as well as the floor. So we will have to like remove the seats out of the car, and eventually we will have to clean the interior of the car like in depth, as well as the seats. And hopefully we can get everything like that sorted out real soon, because I will like this car like nice and clean, specifically for daily use. And this car's fuel consumption is amazing, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. But the furthest I actually drove the car was selecting kilometers in one day, because I just drove it to petrol garage and back, just to throw in some petrol. But thus far I'm really enjoying the car. I have no complaints whatsoever, and I'm just enjoying the car, to be honest. Like, I really can't complain, guys. I really can't complain. Well, guys, this is the view in the car, and it's quite alright. My phone just overheated again, so I'm not sure how long this video is gonna be, but this is the view in the car, and I'm really impressed like with the look of everything. And yes, even like an ashtray, like, yeah. So got the car nice and cleaned, the dash is nice and oily. As many of you guys already know, is that like it's super hot. Specifically here in Stellenbosch, it's like 35 degrees, so that's the reason why my phone keeps on overheating. But what I just said in the video that by accident just got deleted is that I hope you guys are excited for the content that's coming up this month and this year alone, because I feel there's gonna be some good content this month alone with the Uno and the other thing. I still want to do some modifications on the GTA as well. Like, I still want to refurbish the rims and install some polish in the car. But unfortunately, like, everything is like down to a minimal budget this month alone. So I'm gonna try to be creative this month alone with the modifications and to teach you guys a lot of stuff as well, because the channel started out with how to do things, and I think I'm gonna go back to that route a little bit more, go a little bit in depth on how to do things on whatever car, than to just do things without you guys even knowing how it's done. So I hope you guys like that. If you guys have any recommendations what to do on the Uno, and please guys be realistic, because there's a guy that DM'd me and told me, yo, put the VTEC motor in the Uno, and I was like, guy, I bought the car for fuel consumption, I wouldn't mind doing conversion on the car, but I think I really have a VTEC, so that would be a little bit unnecessary. So comment down below what you guys like to see, what you guys would like to be done to the Fiat Uno Mia. I haven't decided on a name yet, so if you guys have any name recommendations for the car, comment down below as well. Yeah, that is dogs, eh? They keep on going on. Well, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Just please keep in mind, please to like and please to subscribe to more related content. Guys, click the notification bell to get notified whenever I'm loading a new video. Guys, comment down below what you guys would like to be seen done to the Uno as well as the other cars. But guys, most importantly, I know I've gone against the saying a lot these past few days, specifically with the yellow thing, but stop racing and go stance. Or should I say, don't go stance and go racing.